Hello, my dear budding doctors. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, Amedicos Notes. Today, we'll be seeing the important short answers, 2 marks and 1 marks in general anatomy. So, let's get started. First question is pronation and supination. Pronation. When palm faces backwards or downwards, as in picking food with fingers from the plate. Supination, when palm is facing forwards or upwards, as in putting foot in the mouth. Example, radio ulnar joints show pronation and supination. After writing this, you can draw the diagram given here. The next question is sesamoid bones. Sesamoid bones are bony nodules embedded in the tendons or joint capsules. They have no periosteum and ossify after birth. The function of sesamoid bones are, they help to resist pressure, they help in minimizing friction, and they help to maintain the local circulation. Example is patella and pisiform. Third question, blood supply of long bone. The arterial supply of long bones is provided by the nutrient artery, periosteal arteries, epiphyseal arteries, and metaphyseal arteries. The venous drainage, there are numerous veins in the red bone marrow which aid in venous drainage, and lymphatics, they drain to the regional lymph nodes. After writing, you can draw this diagram to demonstrate the arterial supply of long bones. Fourth question, histology of bone. For this question, you can draw this diagram and mark the Volkmann's canal and Haversian system containing the Haversian canal and Haversian lamellae and also the canaliculi. Fifth question is the nutrient artery. You can also draw the diagram given in B.D. Chaurasia, General Anatomy, Figure 2.15, the microscopic structure of compact bone. The nutrient artery enters the shaft through the nutrient foramen, runs through the cortex and divides into ascending and descending branches in the medullary cavity. The nutrient artery supplies the metaphysis, medullary cavity and inner 2/3 of cortex. After writing this, please draw this diagram and mark the nutrient artery and its branches. Sixth question, cartilage. Cartilage is a connective tissue composed of cells and fibers embedded in a firm gel-like matrix which is rich in mucopolysaccharides. Cartilage has no blood vessels or lymphatics and also has no nerve supply, therefore it is insensitive. There are 3 types of cartilages: hyaline cartilage, fibrocartilage and elastic cartilage. Seventh question, ossification types with example. There are 2 types of ossification, intramembranous ossification and endochondral ossification. Intramembranous ossification is a replacement of mesodermal model into bone. Example, flat bones of face, mandible and clavicle. Endochondral ossification is a replacement of cartilaginous model into bone. Example, every other bone in the body except the flat bones of face, mandible and clavicle are endochondral ossification. Eighth question, Hilton's law. Hilton's law states that the nerve supplying the joint also supplies the muscles regulating the movement of the joint and the skin over the joint. After writing the definition, draw this diagram where you can see a joint and the nerve supplying both the joint and the muscles over the joint. Ninth question, syndesmosis. Syndesmosis is a fibrous union between the bones held together by ligaments. Example, in inferior tibiofibular joint, it is represented as introcious ligament. Here in this diagram, you can clearly see the introcious membrane between tibia and fibula. 10th question, pivot joint. These are uniaxial type of synovial joints which aid movement in one plane around the vertical axis. Example, superior and inferior radio ulnar joints. And guys, do draw this diagram and mark the superior and inferior radio ulnar joints. And the final question, synovial joint. Synovial joints are the most mobile type of joints. The joint is surrounded by an articular capsule lined by synovial membrane. The synovial membrane secretes a slimy fluid called synovial fluid which help in the lubrication of joints. In this diagram, you can clearly see a synovial joint which is lined by a synovial membrane and having synovial fluid. So that's it for today, guys. Very soon I'll be coming up with the important questions in upper limb. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.